They were warming up and getting ready to begin a new season. The inaugural festivities began with an emphasis on physical health and well-being. 350 members of the community and university family and athletes started at Bragg Stadium for the 5K walk, run, roll, and stroll for healthy families. President Elmira Mangum wanted to emphasize the importance of a comprehensive approach to healthy lifestyles. It was a very successful effort that also brought people together on FAMU campus.
I guess it's a good way for the community to all come together and support her and then support the university and us being part of the team and being with other athletes. It just shows that we have like our full support and we're here like, for her. So I think it's a good cause.
Yeah. It's a good way to promote exercise, being healthy, running, walking.
Participants donated baby clothes and non-perishables as entry fees to benefit healthy babies.
Now, I love the fact that the community has come out, that they're continuing to support us. It's just the beginning of a new season. So now people can understand what we mean by new season. We're open, we're happy about it, and we've got a lot to contribute to the community as well as to the state.
Whether running or walking, everyone had a lot of fun. And they all crossed the finish line at Cascade Park. The presidential inaugural lecture series, The Healthcare Game Change, discussed the reality of health disparities that continue to impact African Americans. Quincy native Dr. Jasmine Bowers reminded participants that we have the power to rid ourselves of many of these killer diseases by making lifestyle changes that will keep us alive.
With the changes in healthcare, we must take responsibility for our health. We must focus on disease prevention and wellness as well as disease detection and treatment. We need to consider lifestyle and changes in dietary habits and follow what's already been established as guidelines for health maintenance.
There are many disturbing health factors that have not changed for African Americans in many decades. Exercise and a healthy diet will combat most of the symptoms of heart disease, diabetes, obesity, and other killers. The President and First Lady have led a national effort through the Affordable Health Care Act, encouraging preventive medicine that stops problems before they become irreversible. Dr. Bowers says, it's up to us. It was more than a wine and cheese. It was another reminder of the diversity of FAMU's research and development program. The College of Agriculture and Food Sciences hosted the inaugural wine and cheese that featured the viticulture program's award-winning wines and displays, showcasing more remarkable agriculture and research finds. The fellowship was great and an opportunity to enjoy the tasty products produced by the College of Agriculture. The gathering was also an opportunity to surprise President Elmira Mangum with nearly half a million in contributions from gala supporters, the Capital Women's Network, FAMU alumni, friends and supporters, and the Reddick family.
So it is with pleasure, Dr. Mangum, that I present to you this check and the amount of $100,000.
The gifts that have been received tonight, I thank you for your commitment to the university, to our students, and to our future. FAMU is just so important to all of us and to our community and to the lives of people all over this country and, in fact, the world.
It was all more proof that it is a new season at FAMU. Sustainability is about what our future will look like. It is the concern of scientists worldwide. Sustainability is the means of keeping our environment and societal structure wholesome. This is the frontier President Elmira Mangum plans to explore with her Sustainability Institute. The symposium discussions, from the community perspective, brought those issues to the forefront.
When we talk about environmental sustainability, when we talk about climate resiliency, when we talk about climate change, we're talking about things that will impact the people that we know and we love.
FAMU Sustainability Institute promises to offer solutions to keep us living in the proper environment. Students held their inauguration for their leaders while also celebrating the 127th birthday of Florida A&M University. It was a Founders Day celebration that would establish a new chapter in the Rattler history book.
And like anything, it's always about reputation and image. And I know we're trying to rebuild that, and I know she's the right person to do that and get the job done.
Jonathan showed off his dance skills with everyone else who was ready to party, including President Elmira Mangum.
This is the glue to this university, the student body and them being engaged and enjoying being a Rattler.
Rattlers celebrated their leadership and a 127-year legacy.
Y'all know how we do it. Here we go. Right hand.
This processional represented many of the nation's dignitaries in higher education from 55 different universities. Most of them were university presidents. They were among the many family and friends attending the installation of Dr. Elmira Mangum, Florida A&M University's 11th president and the first permanent female leader of the 127-year-old land-grant university. The mood of this formal ceremony was one of anticipation of FAMU's third golden age, a season of change.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the 11th president of Florida Agricultural and Mechanical University.
Like President Tucker and others before me who fought to make the educational programs relevant and comparable to programs offered everywhere, I will continue to build upon that legacy as we celebrate his passion and your efforts to build a brand that matters in the 21st century. It's a true honor to stand here and accept this responsibility to preserve the legacy of open doors to an accessible and affordable education that embraces the needs of today and tomorrow. As the 11th president, I am committed to this challenge. It's the beginning of a recovery and a renewal and of all that is great about FAMU. It's a time to recognize and to build upon the contributions this great university has made to the growth of the state of Florida, the nation, and indeed the global community. To everything there is a season and a time, and to every purpose under the heaven. It's time to capitalize on the investments in FAMU, and it's time to end the underfunding. It's a time to build up and not tear down. It's time to chart a clear and certain path out of the pain and passion of recent years. My vision is for FAMU to be part of a global brand that matters in the 21st century and beyond. It is truly a new season, and I'd like to say I just received word that we have a wonderful gift from one of our alumni that have stepped up and provided us with a $5 million gift. So we are on our way. Thank you very much. It's truly a new season. God bless you, and FAMU too. Thank you.
This morning, our hearts are joyful, our minds are grateful, and we are eagerly anticipating what we know will be a new and great season for Florida A&M. God, we ask for your rich blessings on this university and on its president, Dr. Elmira Mangum. Amen.
Pats are back, and that we're looking forward to a successful tenure.
Absolutely.
Also bring our money.
All right.
It was a change in the season, so I mean, we're definitely looking for something different. I'm very pleasant for the upcoming year.
Only excellence and a great thing. And what's the new thing? It's a great day. It's a new season, a new day, and I'm looking forward to it.
Special occasion. I mean, think about it. It's the first female president. It's like a brand new era. We're so excited about it. And she is terrific.
It's undeniable that we should be together. Unbelievable how I used to say I'd find out. The basis you need to know if you don't know just how I feel. Let me show.